Question is, what would you do if it's recording good? What would you do if you have multiple inductors connected in a series there? How do you simplify them? So there's a picture of that. I have two inductors here on the top, dot, 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 that could be more, and one at the end again. So you could have as many as you want to. Well, if we do KVL right here, I'm going to derive that equation. If we do KVL, let's call this current I, sum of the voltage in a closed loop is zero. So we'll begin minus to plus, that's a minus Vs, plus V1, plus V2, plus dot, 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 plus Vy equals to zero. Or Vs equals V1 plus V2 plus now, keep in mind, I'm trying to find one inductor here. We'll call it L equivalent. This is Vs. What value I can use? Just one inductor. That will give me the same result as all of these put together. So that will give me the same current going through this, the same voltage. So what is the value of that? Well, if we do this one, we'll call this V equivalent. If I do KCL in this one, that says Vs, negative Vs, plus V equivalent is equal to zero, or Vs equals V equivalent. Well, what's the voltage across an inductor? V equals what? Isn't that L di dt? Except that'd be V equivalent. This one, V1, is going to be what? L1 di dt. It's the same current going through all of them. Plus L2 di dt. Plus L3, or Ly, di dt. If I factor di dt here, what's left? L1 plus L2 plus Ly. And you want that to equal this one here. I'm saying this has to equal to this. The voltage has to be the same, Vs. The current has to be the same. The only way these two will equal to each other if what? If L equivalent is equal to what? L1 plus L2 plus Ly. So it's just like resistors. We treat inductors like resistors. When they're connected in series, we add them all.
So when it's in parallel, you just do the inverse?
When in parallel, we do the same thing as resistors. 1 over L1 plus 1 over L2 plus 1 over L3 plus 1 over Ln equals 1 over L equivalent.
You still do the product over the sum over 2?
If it's only two of them, yes. And we can prove that by doing multiple inductors in parallel with the current source going through them. So I'll do that quickly there. If I have a current source, we'll call it I sub S. I'm going to derive that equation. There's L1. There's L2. Ln. And I'm trying to replace that with one inductor equivalent to all of these. So the same current source here. L equivalent. Notice this, the voltage we'll call it V here. This current going through that we'll call it I sub L. This voltage here is also V. They have to be the same. But now this current's I sub 1. This current is I sub 2. this current is I sub n. Let me look at the right side. KCL, all the current entering a node equals all the current leaving that node. If I use the top as my node, what's the current going to it? I sub S, and what's leaving that node? I sub L. And if I write I sub L in terms of the voltage, isn't that 1 over L, the integral of V dt? Remember that? V equals L di dt, I equals 1 over L, the integral of V dt. Now, let's do KCL of the node at the top. What's going to it? I sub S, and what's leaving? I sub 1, I sub 2, I sub N. Good news, these are connected in parallel. They have the same voltage. So 1 over L1, the integral of V dt, 1 over L2, the integral of V dt, 1 over Ln, the integral of negative infinity to T V dt. You want that to equal I sub S. Notice they all have the integral as common, so if I factor that out, it's 1 over L1 plus 1 over L2, 1 over Ln, the integral of negative infinity to T, V dt. And that's supposed to equal to what? To this one. L equivalent, we'll call it here. The integral, negative infinity to T, V dt. For these to equal to each other, notice that's the same on both sides, this is the same on both sides. So the only way they're equal to each other is what? 1 over L equivalent equals 1 over L1 plus 1 over L2 plus 1 over Ln. So when they're in parallel, just like resistors, we find the equivalent by using this equation. When they're in series, we do the same thing, just like resistors, we find the equivalent by adding them. Yes?
So only when there is a change in current will there be a voltage across an inductor?
Correct. V equals L di dt. If there's no change in that, the derivative is zero, the voltage is zero. Now, I can derive the equation for capacitors, but I'll just put it there instead of going through the math, the same thing. Well, you're going to find that for capacitors, remember, for a capacitor, I equals what? C dV dt. And V equals 1 over C, the integral of I dt.
So the only change is...
So for capacitors, we know the current is the same here. And I'm trying to find the equivalent here. So this is Vs. I'm trying to find a value. C equivalent. What is that value? And again, if I do sum of the voltage in a closed loop is zero, what's the voltage here? Negative Vs, and this plus what? Using that equation, 1 over C equivalent, the integral I dt equals to 0, which means 1 over C equivalent The integral from negative infinity to ti dt has to equal vs. First, I said I'm not going to derive it, and I'm going through it to derive it now. I just feel guilty there. KVL right here, negative vs plus. This is capacitor 1, capacitor 2, capacitor 3, capacitor n. So it's voltage 1 plus voltage 2 plus voltage 3 plus voltage n. Well, voltage 1 is 1 over C1, the integral. One over C2. I'm not going to write the three, I'll just jump to the n. One over Cn, the integral of negative infinity to t, I dt. And notice the I is the same for all of them. You're going through one branch. The current's not going to change. So if you factor out that 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2 plus 1 over Cn, the integral negative infinity to t I sub dt equals Vs. And you want this equation to equal to this. Well, Vs is the same. The current is the same. The integral is the same. That leaves me with what? 1 over C equivalent equals what? 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2. So notice they're not like inductors. When they're connected in series, inductors, we add them. Capacitors, it's like resistors in parallel. So it's backward.
So if they were like in parallel, you would just add them one.
Correct. Okay. And if they were in parallel, we just add them. So I'll just put that equation. So the capacitors react differently, backward to inductors in terms of combining them. When they're in series, we treat them like resistors in parallel, the same equation. When they're in parallel, we treat them like resistors in series. That's for capacitors. Inductors follows the same pattern, like resistors. So for parallel, I'll just put the answer. I'm not going to derive it. I said I'm not going to derive that one. I'm not going to derive this, definitely. C1, C2, Cn, and I want to replace it with an equivalent value, same source here, C equivalent. And you're going to find out that C equivalent, you can use KCL at the top and the bottom, but if you derive it, KCL equals C1 plus C2 plus Cn. Correct. For if you have two of them, yes. So let's take an example, put capacitors and inductors and go through it to simplify this. Applying both of these, I'm going to put one circuit that has both capacitors and inductors in it to practice. Here is my circuit. .8 henry farad. There's a capacitor here of 1 microfarad.
Henry farad, to what is that one again?
0.8 henry.
The henry.
That's inductor.
Oh, that's
the unit for inductor. Farad, the unit for capacitor. Michael Faraday, that's his name. 6 microfarad, 1 microfarad. Let's put another inductor here of 3 henry, and right on top of that, let's put another one of 2 henry. And the question, can you tell me what the equivalent of this circuit, EQ? Let's begin from the right side. What's the value of this one?
Product over the sum.
Yep, just like resistors in parallel, the product over the sum. 6 times 1, 6 over 7 microfarad. So you can replace that with this value, 6 over 7 microfarad. One microfarad, 0.8 Henry, 3 Henry, and 2 Henry. Now, while we add it, what about this? They're in parallel. What do we do? Add them. 1 and 6 sevens. 13 over 7. And while we add, instead of drawing another picture here, what about these two? Product over the sum, right? 3 times 2?
6.
6 divided by 5, right? So is that 1.2?
Yeah.
And how are these two inductors connected?
In parallel.
These two.
Oh, wait, series.
So the result of that now can be drawn as you add them, and that's 2 Henry. 13 over 7 microfarad. And that's the equivalent circuit, that's equivalent to that one.
So, question.
Yep.
So, the fact that the capacitor is in the middle
doesn't matter. You can flip flop them, won't change anything if you're in the lab. Doesn't matter which one you connect first. Okay, let's take a problem now where we can't really simplify them, but see what will happen to that circuit. So this is a combination, inductance and capacitance combination. I can stop this video. I'll make it two videos here.